Hello guys, I just finished watching the game against Brighton, the Arsenal Brighton game, and I don't even know where to start. I don't know what to say. I don't know how to explain what just happened, but I think we're cost. Honestly, I think we're cost. You can't seem to pull a performance out. Like you can't seem to. It's like at some point we had the performance. Like you felt something was gonna happen. You felt the energy. You could see that there was an energy. But the ability wasn't there for us to be able to get the results or do what we want to do. And I think defensively we are really bad. And this is what I was saying. Like, no matter the combination, now you've got Luis Socrates, you've got Luis Mustafi. Which other combination do we need to use? The goals they scored show that there's a lot to be done defensively. There's a lot. There's no doubt that those two goals, especially the second goal, was a moment of brilliance. The header was so good because I felt the guy was moving away from the post and still heading back into the net. But the first goal was like we had about a million people in the box. We had so many people in the box, and we still managed not to be able to clear the ball, and it's still fell to a Brighton guy. So what is that? Is that down to the football intelligence of our players? Is that down to loss of attention? Is that down to pure ability? I don't know. Because that first goal, yeah, we had too many men for that guy to be able to stick his leg through and still take a shot. This is what I'm struggling to understand. So that's why I said it's difficult for me to explain the game, because I'm not gonna lie to you, I still saw a bit of energy from them. I thought Willock's substitution was spot on. All his final balls were frustrating for we the viewers, for the players on the pitch. There was a time that Aubameyang was so angry at him. It was so obvious that he was just not doing well. In the game, he gets the ball, he carries the ball forward. Final ball, zero. It just doesn't make sense. And then you look at Torreira for instance. I was saying this in my last interview or the last two interviews on AFTV. This guy gets muzzled out. It's as if Torreira needs to go to the gym. He needs to go to the gym and get buffed up, because any little thing he falls, tumbles over. He's as if he's like a kid playing with men that easily gets muscled out. I need to mention Xhaka. In as much as everyone has said whatever bad thing you want to say about Xhaka, as far as I'm concerned, he was pulling the strings. Bad the mistake he made towards the last minute. Apart from that, I felt he pulled the strings. I felt he was the one giving the long balls over the top. I felt he was the one spreading play. Even Ozil wasn't spreading play as much as Xhaka was doing. He gave a few skills to this, surprisingly, from Xhaka. So I would say for me, he was without him in that midfield, we probably would have suffered a bit going forward. When I mean going forward, giving to the guy that was going to do damage. There were several times he gave it to the likes of Aubameyang. There were several times he gave it to the likes of like I said, for them to do damage up front. I felt he did all right today. There's no doubt about it. Defensively, there's just this thing about our defensive structure which is really, really poor. I would say, yeah, Bellerin did okay occasionally going forward, but you can still see that this guy is not there. You can still see there's a lot we still need from him. He's a bit too unidirectional, like one way of playing. He gave a couple of crosses today. Good, thumbs up to him. He did all right for that. But like I said, we are destroying ourselves with our defensive shape. And I don't want people to start calling out Yumbe, because right now it's too early. And if you want to call out anyone, you need to call out the board. It's really that simple. And the investment and the recruitment, it is showing. So many people come to Emirates and they find out that they can play us. It is so obvious that we are easy to play against. Okay? It's a very frustrating night, and it's a good thing I didn't really go for the game, honestly speaking, because I would have been that cold and I would have been angry at the same time. So honestly, it's good at watching on TV. One word of advice, guys, you need to get your shit together. It's really that simple, players. You need to get your shit together. I'm not saying you're not putting effort, but somehow you need to get your confidence back. I would say Pepe coming in today did very well. He kind of lightened up the mood a bit. He was taking on players, and I think that was what we were lacking in the game. Yeah, people were arguing with me that Pepe needs to play. I felt that in the past, Pepe hasn't really imposed himself as much as we wanted. But I'm not gonna lie, today he did very well, Pepe. Thumbs up to you for doing what you did, coming in and showing the manager why you need to be in the team. So I will say yes, you deserve to play for the next game based on the impact I saw from you. But everything else, man, I am really, really disappointed in the boys, seriously. But hey, we move. I'm an Arsenal fan, Gunners for life. You take care, guys. Make sure you subscribe to my channel, yeah? Take care, guys. This is me, Tade. Peace. Signing out.